good evening. So today again I meet my very dear, very beautiful, very intelligent friend Ebru. Thank you Ebru for joining me again.
It's a pleasure.
So a few days ago I was talking to one of my very dear friends. He's an American. And he told me I have very beautiful, very intelligent, very good looking ladies around me and they're all very smart. So he said this cannot be a coincidence. And he knows I'm a very religious person and he knows all my friends, many of my friends are religious. So he asked me a question and I was quite surprised at his question, so I wanted to share this with you. He told me this cannot be coincidence that all my friends are very intelligent and beautiful and good looking. He said, it's not about your religion, right? Actually, it is about my religion, because if you are a Muslim, it's an obligation for you to know about science, to educate yourself, to wear very clean clothes, to be clean and to eat clean. So if you're a Muslim, you should be this way. It's an obligation.
Of course, also the mindset of a Muslim should be very clean. We understand this from the verses of the Quran. Some people have a hard time to believe that we're Muslims. They're surprised that we are modern, well-educated, good-looking, high-class people. This vision totally contradicts with what the bigots practice, yes. Islam. Many people in the world suppose the beliefs and practices of bigots as the real Islam. Yeah. This image has been purposely planted to the minds of people and they're trying to plant seeds of hatred against Islam. Mm-hmm. Especially some bigots are purposely supported by foreign intelligence agencies to keep people away from Islam and to justify their actions against to justify the actions taken against some underdeveloped Islamic countries. However, the truth about Islam is totally different. Islam is far beyond what bigots try to publicize. That's why many people had a shock to see that we're Muslims. In the essence of pure Islam, Muslims should be very modern, very clean, very well-groomed, very chic, very literate, very well-educated and powerful people. All these attributes come from Islam, and our Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, was the most modern people of his era.
You're right.
And if he were to live in our time, no doubt he would be the most modern, most intelligent, most literate man today.
And the most handsome one, and the most good-looking one. Right?
You're right.
So I also want to add something. As a Muslim, you have to know about science, and you have to do something to improve the society. You cannot just sit at home and do nothing. And in a verse, Allah says, I seek refuge with Allah from the accursed Satan. Allah says, only those with knowledge have fear of Allah. And if I need to explain the fear of God here, I should say it's not a primitive fear. It's a very beautiful fear and it stems from losing the love of God.
Yes, it makes you do the right thing, live the right kind of life.
Yeah, you're right.
So it's a good thing.
It's a good
to
thing.
Have yes. fear of Allah.
It's not something which upsets you. So it's not a negative feeling, it's a very positive feeling. So, according to this verse, you should know about science, you should educate yourself. For example, you're walking in the street and you see a very beautiful flower. And how can you appreciate the miraculous creation in that flower? You should know about biology, right? You should know about the photosynthesis that flower is doing there. Without it, you cannot appreciate the creation in it. So in another verse, Allah says, don't you look at the skies and how I created them. How can you look at the skies? You have to use a telescope. So in order to interpret the data, you should know about astronomy. And in another verse, Allah says, I created universe from nothing. So this is Big Bang. How do you understand Big Bang? You should know about physics to understand Big Bang. And in many verses in Quran and in many places, Allah explains the relativity in time. And if you want to understand relativity in time, you should also know about quantum physics.
Of course. I totally agree. Muslim should be well educated to know all these advancements in science and should make research and find out the truth. This is a prerequisite for one to believe in God, because without these knowledge, people cannot properly understand the might of our Creator. I'll read some verses from the Quran, but before I'd like to make one point clear. Our Creator is one, and religion in the sight of God is one. God revealed Judaism and Christianity, and then Islam to confirm the truth within them. So God orders Muslims to believe in all the prophets and all the holy scriptures, reveal to them, Muslim cannot be a Muslim without believing in them.
Sure.
So even we have some different practices on the basis, we have the same morals God commands us. And if one leave his prejudices aside and really want to know pure Islam, he will see that this is the kind of life in society he's longing for.
Sure.
Muslims have the finest taste in every aspect of life. They eat the most desirable food. They wear the most desirable
clothes,
and clean clothes.
Yeah.
They have the most beautiful houses with excellent decoration.
The best they can afford.
Of course.
Yeah.
They look beautiful, they smell beautiful, they have a fine taste in all kinds of art. Now, explain that with the verses of the Quran. I seek refuge in Allah from the accursed Satan in Surah 74, verse 4 and 5.
Mm-hmm.
God says, purify your clothes, shun all filth. What does that mean, Ceyla?
It means you should wear clean clothes and you shouldn't look like a filthy bigot.
Yes, you should avoid uncleanness.
Yeah.
And in Surah 2, verse 125, God says, purify my house for who circle it.
Mm-hmm.
So the houses should be very clean too. In Surah 3, verse 7, God says, those firmly rooted in knowledge say, we believe in it, all of it is from our Lord, but only people of intelligence pay heed.
So you should use your intellect.
Of course, you should be intellectual, you should be wise. You should just understand your environment with this intellect. And so in Surah 23, verse 51, God says, children of Adam, wear fine clothing in every mosque and eat and drink. What does that mean?
When Allah says wear fine clothing, you should wear the finest you can find.
Of course, you should eat the finest and you should be very
clean
and
good looking.
Of course, and the following verse, God says, say who has forbidden the fine clothing Allah has produced for his slaves and the good kinds of provision. So this is very obvious.
Mm-hmm.
No one can forbid the fine clothing to us. This is created for Muslims, this is created for believers, the fine clothing, and also good kinds of provision.
Mm-hmm.
And these are all created for them in this life of the world, and they will be exclusively in the hereafter for them.
Mm-hmm.
Because the following part of the verse, Allah says, on the day of resurrection, such things will be exclusively for those who had who believed during their life in this world.
Mm-hmm.
So, this
so
is
this
for
world,
this life, in this world, Muslims should wear the finest clothing,
mm-hmm.
should eat the finest things, and should live the finest life,
mm-hmm.
and in the hereafter,
it's
also
exclusively for them.
For the believers, it God will create those exclusively for the believers. And this is the lifestyle God orders us to live. This is pure Islam. And other practice which makes a huge discomfort in the society is not Islam, it's bigotry. We can talk on this subject later with you, Ceylan.
Of course, we can also make a video too.
Of course. What do you think about politics?
Politics is also a social science. So, according to Islam, if you're a Muslim, then the world is entrusted to you. Then you should make a change in the world, you should make it a better place. And you cannot just sit at home, eat, drink and sleep. You should really do something. So, how do you do something to change the world? You should use politics, you should know about politics, you should know about strategies, you should be able to develop new strategies, and you should know about the ideologies.
Economics.
So, yeah, you should know about economics, it's very important, and you should know about history in detail, and you should know about geography. So without this, you cannot make a change in the world.
Of course.
And I also want to add something very important here. And if you're a Muslim, you should accept Quran as a whole. You cannot just accept one part and avoid or deny another. So these, what you just stated, are orders of Allah. So if a person is not practicing these, then he is not practicing real Islam, or
yes,
he's not practicing that part of Islam.
Yes, this is something like five times prayer a day. If you don't use your intellect, if you don't follow the advancements in science, if you don't learn, educate yourself, then you're not
practicing that part of
real Islam.
Yeah. So if that person is not knowledgeable, he's not educated, and it's his fault, it's not Islam's fault.
Of course, and also you're responsible for other people too. They're entrusted to Muslims, and the Muslims should be wise enough to care and protect for others. So this is basically how a Muslim should live. I hope this video is enlightening for everyone.